Let's have another look at another unofficial Command & Conquer Red Alert add-on. This time it's Perfect Alert. Yes, we have the original Red Alert. New Alert, Level Alert, and now Perfect Alert. So I think we're at the point where we're exhausting all of the alert-related game titles. So this one here is a 100% unofficial expansions. Yeah, they use plural here. For not for Command & Conquer Red Alert, just for Red Alert. But I'm pretty sure at the time it's like saying Modern Warfare. In 2007, everyone would know you talk about the Call of Duty game. But yeah, here it was pretty much clear that this is Command & Conquer Red Alert. Even though there is actually another game called Red Alert, but that's from the 80s, so never mind. So this one here comes in its original box. And to use this product, you need a licensed version of Red Alert. Not Command & Conquer Red Alert, just Red Alert. At least they don't call it Command & Conquer 2 Red Alert. Or, and this one actually has a proper title, not that like the 1000 level add-on that I still don't know what that one is actually officially called. But anyway, this one here is made by Instant Access. This looks halfway professional, not really sure whether I've done anything else. But overall, this box actually makes a pretty good impression. This cover here has the now only three-pointed star, and it does have a chopper and a shadow, the shadow of a chopper and a tank, which looks kind of slightly greenish. So this one here looks, it doesn't really look like all the other covers, which often had just military hardware on them, or a guy who looked kind of like Red Alert guy, or Command & Conquer Barbarian Dawn guy. This one here looks more like a renegade version of Photoshop or something like that, which is not necessarily a bad thing. But anyway, so let's have a look on the CD. Yeah, there's some text on the back of this box, but it's pretty much identical to what you'll find on the back of this CD here. So put the box aside for a moment. This one here essentially has the same design as the actual box. Inside we find the Perfect Alert CD. These are just very simple installation instructions. This UK flag here looks a little bit like a mix between the Icelandic flag and the Union Jack, but whatever, that's details. Overall, this doesn't really make a bad impression. And here you've got the actual like description text. This is definitely 100% unofficial. I'm not really sure why they highlight that much. I mean, you'd think that not claiming that you're official, but people still thinking that you're official would actually be an advantage. So people would buy your product on account that they think it's maybe another expansion for Command & Conquer. But anyway, these guys here really want to be honest, or maybe they want to be edgy. I don't really know. The nastiest, meanest, most fantastic set of add-ons for Red Alert, trademarked, that you will ever find. I'm not really sure about the nasty part, because we had some really nasty maps in the past, so yeah, I mean, this guy here has some competition, but maybe they didn't know. Actually, check, this one here also came out in spring 1997. Just like almost all these add-ons, it seems that, I mean, think, if I remember correctly, Red Alert came out in autumn or winter of 1996, so it seems that these add-ons all came out within the span of maybe 3 or 4 months, so it's kind of remarkable. This pack is certainly neither produced nor endorsed by the original publishers of Red Alert. Again, they really seem to stress that. But it does contain an unbelievable collection of new missions, extra levels, superb editor, not multiple, and tactics guides that help make Red Alert trademarked even better and gives you more control whether you play Allies or Soviet. Just Soviet. So in this game you can just play a Soviet. Just one guy. You can play multiple allies, but just a Soviet. Also, you can recycle this, which is always good, and which also shows that this is a German product. And this is for all age range, so it's for 18 years and plus, 15 to 17 years, 11 to 14 years, and 3 to 10 years. I'm not really sure how many 3-year-olds have played Command & Conquer Red Alert, and I'm pretty sure the original game is not intended for 3-year-olds. But anyway, so if you know a toddler who really enjoyed Command & Conquer when he was a toddler, or she, leave a comment. So anyway, every part of this pack has been especially written, customized, crafted and tested by Red Alert fans and experts. This is not shovelware or some collection of homemade levels cobbled together. Wow, this one here is almost a deconstruction of this family of unofficial add-ons. They really seem to have played a couple of those other sloppily made add-ons, and basically want to make everything better. So let's see whether they can actually keep their promises, because those add-ons have promised a lot and a lot of them weren't really all that good. Includes the unique and exclusive Red Rules Editor. This Windows editor allows you to change any characteristics of any units you're building in the game. Makes the game easier, make it harder, make it meaner, make it faster. This is nice, but not exactly new. There are a couple of those editors. 5 brand new missions, not just heaps of empty landscape, but actual new missions to complete with real computer AI. Whoa, this game has actual new missions. Not just multiplayer maps, but new missions. I mean, yeah, it's only 5, but that's still 5 more missions than all of the other add-ons, except the ones for the original Command & Conquer, combined had. So wow, my mind just got blown. So the missions are the Siege, Sea of Fear, Genocide 2, whoa, that sounds mean, or Offensive, and Friends and Neighbors. A unique level where the computer acts as your ally against second computer player. That's... I kind of like those missions. I kind of like those missions where the computer actually controls the majority of the forces and you just kind of tactically maneuver them, stuff like that. There was one of the add-ons for the original scenes, you had a mission like that, and I kind of like that. And 100 new levels. Not 1,000, but 100. Selected as the best by Red Alert, trademarked, fans or other fans. Okay. So, I mean, first of all, I actually appreciate that, because 100 multiplayer mobs isn't bad, and we have seen that the more maps those add-ons had, the lower the quality was, or at least it didn't improve in quality at all. But Red Alert fans and other fans? I mean, what other fans? Like, fans of different games? I mean, if they're not Red Alert fans, why did they select the maps? Yeah, whatever. So, ever feel poor? Yeah, I guess so. Our excellent money editor will make you a national lottery winner tool too. Lets you build as much as you can manage. Know that you must make you feel better, surely. That... This is supposed to appeal to, like, socially disadvantaged people. This sounds kind of mean, and that sounds almost political. But anyway, plus heaps of bonus stuff, including tactic guide, just tactic guide, not the tactic guide or tactic guides, mission and levels for the still fantastic and popular Command & Conquer. Oh, so there are some more missions for the original scenes here on there, which is always appreciated because those are usually actual missions. But this one here has actual missions for Red Alert. It's only 5, but as I said before, that's 5 more than all the other add-ons combined had. So yeah, let's not waste any more time and let's get into the game. On to the Command & Conquer 1 missions. So we get these 5 missions here, all done by Al Patterson, and they look reasonable so far. I think we have seen a couple of those before, at least I remember Subversion and Genocide. I might be misremembering that though. And we also get 2 save games for the final Not in GDI missions. Not the end of the missions, but the beginning. So if you want to skip the rest of the campaign, you can take these here. But let's not waste any time and check out what these missions here have to offer. So in this mission here, the first, you have a redonkulous amount of units, and you're also fighting a redonkulous amount of units. Yeah, this isn't actually a real mission. You also fight Viscera, because of course you do. So yeah, and I'm losing forces rapidly here. You should probably play that on a slower speed. Anyway, this isn't a real mission, and that's not just me saying that. So here, this isn't a proper mission. Yeah, it's probably not, but it's effectively like a melee brawl. If you like that kind of thing, yeah, why not? At least it's something new, halfway. So, and it's also a lot of units, so you can basically utilize all the units in the entire Command & Conquer 1 arsenal. So yeah, I can see this being fun, actually. So the next mission, Subversion, is a commando mission. As usual, you have guys behind trees. And the plot here is that one of GDI's top engineers defected to Nord, and he took with him plans for advanced weapons. And now you have to take out their tech center. And if you take out the Hand of Nord, could kill you as well, you get reinforcements. So this is basically a typical commando mission. You've got one good dude, but a really strong dude, and you have to take out a key structure. So From what I can see, I've played this a little bit. Ooh, I guess you were an evil civilian or a technician. This is actually not poorly designed, but it's actually kind of fun, and the map is fairly large. Ooh, enemy commando, that was lucky. The map is fairly large, so there's actually quite a lot of things to do. Here we go, because I brought down that SAM site, I got some reinforcements somewhere. And I think they're just getting toasted, because I hear people getting roasted and screaming. And where are you? Yeah, anyway, so this is a typical commando mission. Not badly designed, kind of fun. Several ways to approach this mission, which is always nice. And overall, yeah, I can see myself playing this. So the next mission is essentially some sort of D-Day mission. So you get a lot of reinforcements here, but you also get wiped out super quickly. And your goal is to take out all these turrets here, which is not easy because there's just so much not on this map. And you should probably play that on a slower speed. In any case, once you have taken out all the stuff here, you get reinforcements, then you have to take over a base and establish your own presence in the area and then wipe out Nod. So this is not easy. Man, this Nod artillery, they're pesky. Come on, get over here. So yeah, this mission is actually kind of fun. I'm not really sure whether your reinforcements are unlimited. I think they're not, but at least I didn't have the feeling that you lack troops, really. This really does feel like D-Day. You're losing troops rapidly, and you're facing heavy enemy resistance. Come on, take out that guy. Thank you. And yeah, this is... Actually, I kind of like this. It's just because of the insane amount of troops you're burning through. It's pretty fun. Please blow that up. Or maybe not. Or maybe blow up this turret here. Yeah, this mission, there's more to this than just this, so later on you have to take out the artillery. You have to take out... Ooh, these launchers, I'm supposed to get past those. And did you just move up the river? You're not allowed to do that. It's against the rules. So anyway, let's take out this commando here. And this turret here if possible. And look at that, even more guys. This mass amount of units, it's just insane. But as you can see, in high numbers, even riflemen get somewhere. Yeah, this mission is actually, it's a lot of fun. I think this might actually be the best mission on this add-on, just because of the absolutely asinine amount of units you have at your disposal. And they never really seem to stop coming. So let's take these guys here. Yeah, we have now taken over this beach here. And let's take out this guy here. And anybody left here? Doesn't look like it. And there should be a commando here, because I'm getting taken out by... Whoa. Yep, and I got wiped out again. So am I finally out of troops? It almost seems like it. Wow. So yeah, this, I guess I should have handled this a little bit better, because now all I have left are a bunch of riflemen. But yeah, anyway, this mission is a lot of fun. And I failed, obviously. Yeah, still a lot of fun. Just maybe turn down the game speed a little bit and you'll be good. So this mission here, infiltration, it's a base building mission, but only later. First you have to free Agent Delphi, who has been captured while... been captured while investigating this Nod base here. And what the hell are you doing? Why were you landing there? Jesus, you're suicidal. So anyway, there's this Nod base here, and we have to free Delphi, who's being held in the north. Later on we'll get an MCV. And you have a lot of more range than I remember you to have. But anyway, you guys please get over here. And yeah, another mission that's actually reasonably well designed. Yeah, all these missions here are actually pretty... What? You can reach artillery? Okay, even... That's ridiculous. I don't recall turrets being able to reach artillery even if it's directly in front of them, but anyway, that's just me. So whatever, another mission that's actually quite well designed. Overall, these Command Conquer 1 missions are pretty... They are pretty well designed, they're quite fun. They also feel like official missions, at least in the sense that they, apart from that one mission, the first one where it's just a massive battle, it doesn't really feel too gonzo. So, and here's Delphi. There we go. And now he should reveal the location of that tech center, and I should have gotten reinforcements somewhere. Okay, anyway, not too important. Oh, these missions are only, they're quite few numbers, they're only 5 missions, but nevertheless they are well designed, and it's better than yet another volley of multiplayer only maps, so yeah, I would definitely recommend these. Now, before we start with the single player maps, a quick look at the multiplayer maps. They seem to be named reasonable. They still don't tell you what kind of map size you have most of the time, but at least the names make some sort of sense, and I think they do all mention their authors, so... And yeah, ooh, we have the famous new map. And for the most part, these seems to be actual new maps and not just recycled maps from other add-ons, so it's not too bad of a first impression. Alright, here's the first map, and look at that. I'm trapped. I can't unfold my MCV, and I can't even move an inch. I can't even turn around. I'm completely trapped. I'm completely immobilized. And all I could do if I want to end this game is wait for the AI to come over and kill me, which I'm not even sure is possible because this area looks kind of hard to reach, so if I'm unlucky, I won't even be able to loot this mission, so yeah, this is not a good start. Okay, this one's here's next. It actually works. I was in a position where I could actually get myself started and wasn't completely trapped. But this is a very low effort map. I mean, look at this road here, look at these beaches here, look at this transition, which basically isn't present. This is a very low effort map. It's not terrible as a multiplayer map from a gameplay point of view, but come on, put some effort into it. Just a little bit. I mean, it's just an aesthetic thing, but I really want my maps to look consistent. It doesn't have to be the most beautiful map in the world, but at least choose roads or road tiles that really fit together. It's not that difficult, especially not if you're producing this for a commercial product. So this one here is kind of interesting. You start all of you start on a really, really small island, so you're really, really close to one another, and as a result, you're very likely to get stomped or stomp one of your enemies. In this case, I sort of stomped Blue, which worked reasonably well. The downside is that it's basically like a Mexican standoff. So it's depending on how many factions you have on the map, it's likely that two factions just fight it out and the other factions then take them over because they're weakened. So it's not really a fair map, to be honest. It's still interesting as a sort of one-off game where you just see who will be the survivor, but for an actual like semi-competitive multiplayer map, it's not all that well designed, to be honest, but it's, I had fun with it and the map works. It's consistently designed and generally spoken, it's not too bad. And now Brown is attacking me. Yeah, that's what happened. So Brown was basically left alone for most of the time, so Brown had time to build up his forces properly, whereas I had to fire. Oops, now I'm out of power. On low power, now I'm out of... I was already out of breath because I had to fight Blue, but on the plus side, I can take over Blue's construction yard, so if Blue's another faction, I can have all technologies at my disposal, which is kind of nice. But this was basically just more dumb luck how this game here went. Overall, it's not too convincing. So, this is a famous new map, and it's just a blank map. There's nothing on there, it's just a blank map. Yeah, overall these maps are a little bit of a disappointment. They're not the best maps, to be honest. Not all of them are as terrible as the ones I've shown you. The ones I tested first basically turned out to be among the worst maps here, but overall none of the maps are really all that special. Yeah, I can't mine here because there's nothing to mine. I did build the refinery nevertheless, because why not? And because I needed to access stuff from the tech tree. Yeah, overall these multiplayer maps are really disappointing, but we are mainly here for the single player maps because this add-on actually does have single player maps for once. So yeah, let's check out those. Alright, here we are. It's actual missions, all 5 of them, we have them here. This one here is called Genocide 2 because there's actually a mission for the first Command & Conquer here that's called Genocide. And these ones here, They're all, in my opinion, pretty well designed, but let's waste any time and actually check them out. So this is Genocide 2. It is pretty genocidal because you have very few troops and you're attacked by these dogs here straight away. And even on a low speed, it's not that easy to micromanage that. Oh, and there's also Flame Guy, which doesn't really help, to be honest. Oh, and lost even more guys. Come on, kill him. And kill the dog, thank you. And yeah, there's not a whole lot you can do here. I think you get more reinforcements later. But overall, it's a rather brutal mission, especially because there's a mammoth tank up there, which is not nice. Yeah, this mission here doesn't mess around, though there's even more dogs. Bam, and we have allied grenadiers for some reason, yeah. Just like some of the older add-ons. These ones here just couldn't resist giving you all kinds of units that your side is not going to supposed to be having, but yeah, that's okay with me. It adds some variety. And since these missions aren't official missions, it doesn't really feel all that bad, to be honest. Let's take these guys. I still don't want to take on that mammoth tank, to be honest. So now we have to take over this base here in the north. Something interesting, if you take out one of the Tesla coils, then the other Tesla coils get activated, because apparently the Soviets don't have enough power. And by the way, the plot behind this mission is just that you have to take out the Soviets, but time's limited, so even though there's no actual timer in the mission, so you have to just take all your troops, storm the Soviet base, and take out everything. I'm pretty sure they give you an MCV or engineers later, because I did mention that you're supposed to take over the base. But yeah, we'll see. Anyway, they have a ton of Tesla coils. Way too many Tesla coils for my taste. But I did get even more tanks, and this is a little bit like it's a little bit like a D-Day mission, because you get a lot of troops and you're also going to lose a lot of troops. And what are you doing there? So let's get through here. Whoa. What the hell are you doing? And of... Oh yeah, I do get some engineers. I should probably get them out of there, because they're currently getting attacked. Guys, what are you doing? Anyway, so yeah. And where did you guys come from? Anyway, still not a bad mission. It's quite interesting. First you have to do something else than losing all your engineers but one, like I did. And then you have to take over the Soviet base here, which is now all almost impossible because this guy is going to get killed very soon. Oh, and he actually just phased through that tank, which is nuts. Anyway, if you handle that a little bit better than me, then this is actually quite a lot of fun, because if you take over the Soviet base and you have a massive brawl at the beginning, and then if you take out the rest of the Soviet forces. So yeah, not a bad mission. Yeah, this mission here is another tactical mission, so you do have quite a lot of forces, but so do the Soviets, which is why you basically get slaughtered at the beginning. You also have Tanya, and your objective is simply to take out all the Soviet forces. And this cannon here, always take out the cannon. And you also have allied mammoth tanks, because as usual, the mapmakers just couldn't resist turning this map into a map where like all the forces are mixed, no matter what side you're actually on. And did they just try to bomb Tanya? Anyway, so this mission here is not easy. I didn't even manage to kill half the Soviet forces because stuff like that. And they just jump you so hard, so early. I'm not really sure whether you're supposed to get any MCV at one point. I don't think you are, but I'm not really sure. Anyway, pretty challenging mission, but generally not bad designed either, and I probably should have utilized this cruiser here a little bit better, but yeah, whatever. Maybe next time. This mission here is a classic base building mission, and it's not too hard at the beginning because you get a pretty decent amount of reinforcements and the Soviets don't jump you too hard, even though they have these annoying mix. But later on, this mission becomes absolutely brutal. The Soviets, they jump you with a lot of stuff. They're like attacks like this. And if you're not prepared for that, you just get stomped. And yeah, I'm not really sure how to stop this. I did get a little further the first time I played this, but even if you manage your forces really well and you pump out miners really, really quickly, I'm not quite sure how to stop an onslaught like this. Because just look at this. This is way more than I had at that point. Even if I had managed my base a little bit better, which admittedly I hadn't really done. It's not easy. So another really challenging mission, but I'm pretty sure if you get a little bit further here, it's also a lot of fun. So this mission here is called Epic Confrontation, and it's quite interesting in the sense that you have an ally. You've got these green allies here. So you not only do build up your own base and defend your own forces and try to take on the Soviets, no, you also have to protect your allies. Well, you don't have to protect your allies, but it's very beneficial to do so, so you should do it. And overall, this is very fast-paced. The AIs, they jump one another pretty much straight away. And it's pretty fun to coordinate yourself with the AI. I mean, the AI isn't really all that smart, to be honest. But it's kind of interesting to fight alongside a computer-controlled opponent, which is something you don't really do a whole... Oh, sorry guys, I almost dropped the power plant on you. Which is something you don't really do a whole lot in the official campaign missions. So yeah, this one, I like this concept a lot. It's a little easier than all the other missions, it's not quite as brutal, but it's nevertheless a pretty decent challenge. And you do have to watch out not only for your own forces, but also for your ally and keep him up as well. Otherwise, this mission gets a lot harder. So the final mission is called Ore Onslaught. Your goal is to take out a massive ore mining facility from the allies. And there's also a massive amount of ore on this map, and the idea is that you take out the allies within 1 hour, which is not all that much considering it's in-game time. And the idea is basically, yeah, the allies, they have a lot of Soviet units, they have heavy tanks and mountain tanks and whatnot, but that doesn't really matter all that much. And the idea is that instead of building up your forces a little bit more carefully, what you do is basically just get as many miners as you can, mine as quickly as possible, build a bunch of arms factories, and then just build the world's largest heavy tank army and just steamroll the allies, which is actually a lot of fun. So I managed to beat this mission. It's not easy because the allies, they harvest a lot of stuff as well, but you also get a decent amount of reinforcements. And at least by halftime you should have a ridiculously huge heavy tank army, and you should be able to just steamroll the allies if you do it right. And for some reason the Get Tanya to the Helicopter message appears here. It seems that it's some sort of artifact from the mission this one here was based on, because if you restart this mission, then this mission becomes Tanya's story, where that is one of the goals. But anyway, that's probably just some sort of scripting artifact, whatever. Anyway, this mission, as so many other missions in this add-on here, had the theme of basically just having an absolutely massive army and taking out an absolutely massive enemy army as well. So overall, I like these quite a bit, and I would definitely recommend this mission specifically and also this add-on in general. Altogether, Perfect Alert is without a doubt the best unofficial Command & Conquer Red Alert expansion, mainly because it actually is an expansion and not just a collection of multiplayer maps which were poorly designed at best and downloaded from the internet without actually designing anything at worst. And even though the multiplayer maps on this add-on here are pretty mediocre and some of them actually pretty bad, that's not really all that important. You can get all the multiplayer maps you want from the official expansions, which come with a lot of maps. Overall, the 10 missions this game here comes with, they're actually all pretty good. None of them is terrible. Many of them are quite challenging and actually quite fun. And it's only 10, but that's still 5 more missions for Red Alert than all these other add-ons had combined. And I'm not really sure why. It doesn't really seem to be a technical problem. And I can kind of see that some people would cash on the multiplayer maps alone, because Red Alert does have the skirmish mode, which the original Command Conquer didn't, at least not with a working AI. But I'm still kind of surprised that nobody else even attempted to make some poorly made maps to cash in on those, but I guess that was just limited to the first Command Conquer. And even the maps for the first Command Conquer on here seem to be originals, I haven't seen them before. Even those maps seem to be pretty good. So overall, this add-on is a lot better than all of these add-ons here. And if I would recommend you a single Command Conquer Red Alert add-on that's unofficial, then it's definitely Perfect Alert. So thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time.